My name is Carlos, and today I'll show you a little device that has helped me stick to habits and chores, and this also happens to be the absolute simplest project for an Arduino. And that's it, let's go! It all started with this guy, which gets up every day at 4 in the morning to vacuum the kitchen floor. However, after 3 or 4 days, the little dirt container fills up, and if I don't clean it, the whole thing goes from being a dirt catcher to more like a tourist guide for dirt. And it's infrequent enough that I would always forget, especially since there are no signals on the container telling me that it's full. Like a good millennial, the first thing I tried was to set an alarm on my phone that would go off every 3 days. But if I was somewhere else or if I was busy, I would just dismiss it and forget later. I came up with the idea of a very simple light that's always there, and when it's time for me to clean it, it'll just start blinking. And I can only see it, of course, when I'm right there, so I'm much more likely to do it. But even if I'm busy at the moment or for whatever reason I just can't, the light will just keep blinking, so it's no problem. When I finally get around to do it, I just push a button and that resets the whole thing, so the light turns off until 3 days later when it's time to do it again. I like this because it's one of those really simple things that actually works really well. Let me show you what I did. All right. But that was indeed my first prototype. It was really super simple. If you've ever used an Arduino, you know that the most basic project that it comes with is a blinking light using the LED that's already integrated in it. So all I had to do was add a 3-day delay at the start, which is just this line. And that crazy number is 3 days, but in milliseconds. And for the button, I didn't have to do anything there either. Arduinos come with an integrated reset button. So all I really did was put black tape over the power light that's on all the time. And that's just to make the light that's blinking a little bit easier to see. Then I taped the whole thing to a power brick, and here you go. I present my entry to the simplest but useful Arduino project. I actually used this version for about a year, and it worked so well that now I wanted to improve on it and make a few more to remind me of all the things. All these activities have a different amount of days in between resets, so I needed a way to change that without having to go back into the code for each of the devices. So I went with these dip switches, and they're not fancy at all, but they're small and they're easy to change and see what the setting is without the need of a screen. Using binary numbers and 5 switches, I can select any amount of days between 0 and 31. For the button, I had these from a different project, and they're buttons with an integrated light in it, which is perfect. And that's it. Let's get building. I accidentally soldered these 2 contacts together. I tried to remove the solder, but I couldn't get it all out, so lesson. Don't be too lazy to change your soldering iron tips to the right size. And here it is. This one actually was a bit of a pain to make, so before making more, I switched from regular prototype boards to these Perma Protos by Adafruit. And they're very similar, they're just pre-connected on the back, so they're much easier to solder. And since I had to tweak the design to fit the new boards anyway, I also changed the look because, well, I just wasn't thrilled by the clock tower look on this one. So I got some arcade buttons that are a bit more fun and visible, and I ended on a round design for the case. It's not perfect, but I like it much better. I also made a version with legs that kind of looks like a cement mixer, but meh. Most importantly, it works really well, and I'm happiest with the one I put by my bike that reminds me to exercise. And usually it's a bike ride, so that's why I put it there. And I finally got consistent at doing it at least every other day. I'm not an expert at habits by any means, but from the books that I've gone through, they tend to split the habits into three parts. And the first one is the signal, which tells you to start and execute the action. And then once you execute the action, you get a reward. The classic example is brushing your teeth. And when you feel that roughness on your teeth, that tells you that's your signal, and that tells you to execute the action, which is brushing your teeth. And then you get that reward, which is that minty feeling, the clean feeling in your mouth. And actually, mint itself does nothing to clean your teeth. But they realized early on that when they added mint or any other strong flavor into the toothpaste, that people stuck to the habit way more precisely because the reward is clearer. And that's what I was trying to do with this project, to kickstart this chain of events for habits or things that I want to do that don't have a clear signal to get them started. While I was editing this and thinking about the toothpaste, I added a tweak to the code so that when you push the button, the light goes away as before, but now it also gives you some blinks to acknowledge that you pushed it. And I don't know if that will improve adherence, it's too soon to tell, but I'm hoping that it does so by creating a more satisfying reward for the brain, kind of like the mint on the toothpaste. And anyway, I hope that's helpful. If you're interested in getting one or making one, check out the link in the description. And don't forget to subscribe right here, I think there. And I'll see you on the next one. Bye.